Hi everyone, this video is going to demonstrate the steps to use Place Adaptive Simulation within AutoTURN to place a simulation on a pre-drawn path in a drawing. AutoTURN is used to confidently analyze road and site design projects including intersections, roundabouts, bus terminals, loading bays, parking lots, or any on-off street assignments involving vehicle access checks, clearances, and sweat path maneuvers. In this drawing we have a shopping center to the left and a parking lot. The Adaptive Simulation tool is going to allow me to determine whether the vehicle can safely enter the parking lot, navigate through it, and then exit back onto the main road. To get started, I am first going to click on the Settings tool button and set the units to match the drawing. In this case, they are going to be set to feet. To the right, in the Next tool button, I can make adjustments in the properties. In this case, I want the tires and tire treads to show within the vehicle's 2D category. Next, we need to select the design vehicle that we wish to use for our analysis. To do that, I am going to click the Vehicles button where I can select the vehicle of interest. In this case, I am going to use an Astro 2018 passenger vehicle. So looking back at the parking lot, we can see that there is a pre-drawn path shown in red that goes through it. Before I try that one out, I'm going to pan to the right just to demonstrate the basics of placing the adaptive simulation. Sections of the pre-drawn path can be picked by first clicking the Place Adaptive Simulation button and then picking the connected geometry lines to run the vehicle's anticipated path. In this case, I am selecting basic lines and arcs. However, it is also possible to select extended polylines as well as complex chains on the Bentley platform. When finished selecting the elements to add to the path, any area outside can be left-clicked to tell AutoTURN that I am done. Immediately, I am previewed with the vehicle's adaptive simulation following the intended centerline path. Zooming in, we can see where the vehicle starts, and then at the end of the path, we can see an arrow indicating the direction of travel. This is the end of the path. So I'm going to click OK to finalize, and here I have generated my first simulated path using adaptive simulation. Moving back to the parking lot, placing the adaptive simulation will be the same iterative process. In this case, the lines and arcs have been all connected into one large polyline, and as a result, this will only involve one click to put together the vehicle's anticipated path. So as usual, I'm going to first click Place Adaptive Simulation, and then I'm going to click on the polyline. Also, same as the first example, the simulation type is going to be set to centered. When complete, we can see the Astro 2018 passenger vehicle has successfully completed the path without any conflicts, and the vehicle also does not exceed any of the turning characteristics specified in the design guideline. Onto the main road, I can run an adaptive simulation with an offset to the road edge traveling northbound. As usual, this will involve me selecting geometry elements of the road edge. This involves clicking lines that shift slightly in the east direction as I move north to compensate for an overhead bridge support column. After being prompted the Place Adaptive Simulation interface, I am going to set the simulation type from centered to offset left and set the offset distance to be 3 feet. This is ideal because the lane width is 12 feet and the width of the vehicle is 6 feet. As a result, the vehicle will have a clearance on each side of 3 feet, which puts it in the exact middle of the lane. The nice thing about this adaptive simulation feature is that even as the road changes direction slightly, the software will react smoothly to this transition. Thank you for watching our how-to video on placing an adaptive simulation. In this video, we covered a simulation check on whether this passenger vehicle can successfully navigate through a parking lot as well as travel down a road with the direction changing slightly. We hope this video has been helpful and informative and you have learned something new today. If you enjoyed this video, please check out our playlist with more videos on similar topics. These videos go into more depth and provide more insights and detailed analysis on vehicle simulations using AutoTURN. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to stay updated on our latest videos. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments section below. Thank you again for watching, and we'll see you in our next video.